everybody. I hope you're having a great day. We're almost done with our week and wanted to share some exciting news. We've had a word study committee. On that committee has been Christy Barta, Bree Roon, Stephanie Brown, and Tammy, and myself. And we've probably been meeting since maybe February, March, and really looking at a variety of word study programs. And I'd love to share that we are recommending for classes in grades K through 3, the Foundations program. So I just wanted to share with you a little bit about why we started this work and our process along the way. So we really took two different perspectives as we were looking at word study, and really two different elements motivated us in our work. First of all, from a school perspective, this has been, as we all know, an anomaly year. And with the pandemic, we've really seen kids make a lot of great growth, but then a couple of kids and a group of kids still continuing to struggle. So given the pandemic, we knew that for next year and years to come, the focus on word study would be an important one for us. We also saw an increase in RTI and SPED students in some grade levels, and also kids sort of remaining in RTI over the years and then transitioning to SPED. So that sort of prompted some of our work. And we also know that we're always looking for ways to improve. So just kind of even reflecting on our own practice and where we are, and just wanting to look at some new opportunities under that umbrella of continuous improvement. Also, there was some information happening at the state level. You might have heard in some of the district communication that under some legislation for grades K through 3 under the READ Act, the state is talking about required curriculums, and they're talking about that for tier 1 or whole group reading, but also for phonics. They're only looking at grades 1 through 3 for that READ Act because it's tied to early literacy, and that's where our READ Act funding targets. So they were also recommending some state approved curriculums. There's different curriculums for whole group reading and a full reading program, a full tier 1 reading program, and then some supplemental programs that target phonics in particular. So we were prompted to look at word study from our school perspective, but also some changes happening at the state level. From the state level, with regard to phonics programs only, they were really saying we could look at Foundations and Benchmarks full literacy programs. So not just Benchmarks phonics program, but also their whole workshop program. So that would be something we would implement instead of Lucy. Lucy's program was not on the state list. OG is also on the supplemental list, so we were considering that for some time as well. So the team originally, prompted by both the state and the school, we got together and we outlined our beliefs. You'll see our belief statements below. And there were a variety of things that sort of drove us. We were really looking for a systematic program. We are hoping for a program K through 5. We also wanted one that had a variety of word study elements: phonics, phonemic awareness, spelling, morphology in the older grades. A clear and concise scope and sequence across the grades was really important, something we didn't necessarily have consistently now. We were also looking for an assessment component and really wanted something that included a multi-sensory approach. So really we were looking at OG, Foundations, and Benchmarks whole reading program. And we really felt like as we look through these, that Foundations was a clear one. We always wanted to provide people choice and options. However, the programs were really different. You could see on our attached program reviews some pros and cons for both. Both Foundations and Orton-Gillingham, or OG, were the only multi-sensory program. The issue with OG, which we will implement in RTI and SPED next year, the problem was the training that was required was really too intense. It was 5 full days. We felt like we couldn't quite ask for teams or teachers to do that on top of the state reading training. And really, if we scheduled that through the school year, that would have been all of our professional development next year. And as we know, we're excited to continue with math and work on science. So that one didn't feel realistic to us. And Benchmark also really felt like a scope and sequence and a basal. So we are putting forward the recommendation for foundations for next year. We have some leadership opportunities that are listed below for this summer, and we really hope to look for some morphology to support fourth and fifth grade. Unfortunately, foundations only moves for kindergarten through second, so we're a little disappointed in that, but we really feel like as our only manageable multi-sensory program, this really was the one that felt right for us. We did really think about benchmark and did an extensive review of teaching videos on all of the programs and looked at the curriculum. That one feels very much like a basal and very outside of our philosophy here at Gold Rush. So wanted to explain that to you. Also wanted to show you some next steps. We will have an optional staff meeting for you to have a chance to ask some questions. There's some links below on our scope and sequence, and also some summer opportunities. There's tons of trainings over the summer. If you're interested in those, they are absolutely optional, but if you're interested, let us know. Thanks so much. Feel free to come to our staff meeting on Tuesday, and we would love to answer any questions that you have along the way. A huge thank you to our Word Study Committee, and we look forward to continuing that into next year as people who are interested in some summer trainings and providing some staff development with us in August sign up. So thank you for everybody that helped out, and we will continue this conversation Tuesday morning. Thank you.